What's up, guys? Welcome to Kisi Unlocked. My name is Drake, and I'm here to guide you through the world of access control. Let's get into it. Today, we will talk about alarm panels, their benefits, and the installation process. This is an alarm panel. This panel is capable of detecting intrusion and responding quickly. It detects intrusion using a variety of tools, including motion sensors, door contact sensors, and glass break sensors. When an intrusion is detected, an alarm panel can set off sirens, alert you, call for help, and initiate other emergency procedures. Kisi has a built-in intrusion detection system, but third-party alarm panels can also be integrated with the Kisi system to combine legacy intrusion detection with modern access control. Alarm panels bring peace of mind to your home or office. If anyone attempts to enter, you will know an appropriate action will be taken. By connecting an alarm panel to Kisi, you get access to powerful cloud-based tools. You can control when your alarm is armed, and you will get notified by email and mobile notification if your alarm is ever triggered. By combining your alarm system with your access control system, you can reduce false alarms and ensure your spaces are secure. For this installation, you will need a Kisi Controller Pro 2, an alarm panel, and a small flathead screwdriver. Be sure to unplug the controller before wiring anything. Identify the general input pins on the left side of the Kisi controller. The alarm panel will communicate to Kisi what mode it is in through these pins. Wire one of the general input pins to the disarm relay NO port on the alarm panel. Connect the COM port of this relay to a GND pin on the Kisi controller. Wire another general input port to the violated relay NO port on the alarm panel. Connect the COM port of this relay to a GND pin on the Kisi controller. Repeat this for the armed away relay on the alarm panel. If you wish to configure an arm stay mode as well, do this process a fourth time. Identify the relays on the right side of the Kisi controller. The controller will communicate to the alarm panel when to arm or disarm through one of these relays. Wire the NO port of one of the relays to the key switch on the alarm panel. Wire the ground of the key switch to the ground of the Kisi relay. Now let's set up the software. First, we need to create a zone. Sign into Kisi. Open your place. In the left-hand menu, click on Intrusion Detection. Click on Add Zone. Enter the zone name. Open the Alarm Type dropdown and select Third Party Alarm Integration. Click Save. Now we need to configure the zone. Click on the zone you created above. Toggle on Enable Intrusion Detection. Scroll down. Select the Alert Policies tab. Enter the email address of the user that should be notified upon policy violation when the alarm is triggered. Click on the user to configure the notification preferences. Next, click on the Alarm Controller tab. In the Relay field, define the relay that is connected to your alarm siren. In the Arming Delay field, define how long the alarm controller should wait before arming. Click Save. Next, click on the Contact Sensors tab and configure it. Next, click on the Doors tab and click on Add Door. Select the door you want to add. You can also enable the exterior door if the door is used to leave or enter the zone. Click on Add. Next, click the Away tab. Select the action that the relay must detect for the system to change to Away mode. Note: Away, disarmed, and violated states must be connected to a contact sensor. The stay state is optional depending on your alarm system requirements. If you found this video helpful, be sure to leave a like down below. Smash that subscribe button and ring the notification bell to stay up to date on the latest in access control and physical security. Leave a comment if you have any questions and we'll try our best to get back to you. Thanks for watching.